Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, dear brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to a new episode of Major Sins in Islam. These major sins that every Muslim should be conscious of, aware of, knowledgeable of, so they could keep away from it. These major sins, it is the responsibility of every Muslim to know them. And ignorance is not an excuse. Ignorance, not knowing these major sins, is not an excuse. Someone who is falling into those major sins and committing those major sins, for them to later on say, I don't know of them, I didn't know of them, that's not an excuse. It is your duty as a Muslim to seek knowledge. It is your duty as a Muslim to know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from you and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders you to keep away from. It is your duty to know what's halal, and it's your duty to know what's haram. It is your duty to go and seek knowledge. This is the responsibility upon you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not accept an excuse of anyone who says, I didn't know. Only to those who are new in Islam. The only those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept their excuse that I didn't know, it's those who just embraced Islam and they've only been Muslims for few days or few weeks or few months. But someone who is born a Muslim, grew up amongst a Muslim family, in a Muslim environment, there is no excuse for them to say, I didn't know. You must seek knowledge. You must know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to know. And one of the major sins that you find many Muslims neglect and not take it serious is not fasting a day in the month of Ramadan. Not fasting a day in the month of Ramadan, obviously without a valid excuse. There are some days, there are some times that Islam or the Sharia permits us not to fast the days of Ramadan. Such as a woman who is pregnant or a breastfeeding woman or someone who is a traveler or someone who is ill or any other excuses that the Sharia finds and sees a legitimate excuse for someone not to fast the days or the day of Ramadan. But for someone not to fast the day of Ramadan without any excuse, just because they are too scared from hunger, or just because they are too lazy, or just because they can't be bothered, or just because they are too attached to their food or to their water, well, this is a major sin. Let us know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had mentioned about the month of Ramadan. Allah, our Lord, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Our Lord, He says in the Quran al-Kareem, all those who believe, Allah had decreed upon you to fast the month of Ramadan, the way He had decreed on the previous nations before you, fasting. So fasting was decreed. Fasting was decreed on the nations before us. But they had different way of fasting than what we fast and the way we fast. We fast the month of Ramadan and we fast 29 or 30 days from dawn to sunset. The previous nations had a different way of fasting. Allahu A'lam how their way or form of fasting. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. So you could increase your piety. So you could get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fasting gets you closer to Allah azza wa jal. Fasting protects you from falling into the evil deeds. Fasting protects you from falling into the haram. Fasting protects you from falling into what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had forbidden. That's why my brother and my sister in Islam, you must fast. As long as you reach the age of maturity and you are sane and you have the ability to fast, you're not ill or you don't have this chronic illness that you cannot fast, then you must fast. And if you do not fast, you are committing not just a minor sin, you are committing a major sin. A major sin, a kabira from the kabair, that nothing will wipe that sin except that you repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let me inform you of a hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, if someone misses out on one of the days of Ramadan, did not fast that day for no reason, he does not or she does not have a valid excuse. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if they fast the rest of their life, it is not enough to make up for that one day. Amazing. One day of the month of Ramadan, one day of the holy month of Ramadan, someone missing out on that month, someone missing out on that day, if they fast the rest of their life, it is not enough to make up that day. Can you imagine for those who have been missing out on the month of Ramadan and fasting the month of Ramadan for years, not only they miss out on one or two days, but they miss out on months. Some people for years and years, they never fasted one day. Can you imagine one day, if you fast the rest of your life, you would never make up that one day that you missed out in the month of Ramadan? The Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum said, we never found something a lot more major, a lot more greater of a sin than someone leaving the salah, not paying the zakat, and not fasting the month of Ramadan. Why? Because the month of Ramadan and fasting the month of Ramadan is an obligatory action, is a farida, an obligatory action that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had decreed and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had commanded us. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Islam is based and Islam is built on five fundamentals, five foundations. And then the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam said, is to testify that there's no God except Allah and Muhammad his messenger, and to perform the prayers, and to pay zakat, and to fast the month of Ramadan. Yes, the month of Ramadan is an order, is a commandment. It's not an optional. You don't have the option, and you don't have the option or the choice to fast the month of Ramadan or not. You, as a Muslim who believes in Allah Azza wa Jal and believes in the Day of Judgment, and you are mature and sane, and you have the ability to fast, you must fast the month of Ramadan. You must fast the month of Ramadan. And not only that, if you don't, if you fast the rest of your life, it's not enough to make up that day. No, that it is not enough to make up that day, but it is also a severe punishment in the hellfire, wal-iyadhu billah. Why? Just because you don't want to give up some of your food and give up some of your water and some of your desires for 12 hours or less or more. You don't want to give up your desires from Fajr till Maghrib, from dawn till sunset. And you don't want to give up those little things for the sake of Allah. Well, I'll tell you one thing. Give up that is a lot more easier than the punishment of the hellfire. You rather have patience on starvation for 12 hours or more or less. You rather have patience on starvation from Fajr till Maghrib, from dawn till sunset, than having patience on the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the way a believer thinks. At the end of the day, it's not my option or my choice to disobey Allah azza wa jal. You might disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You might disobey Allah Azza wa Jal, but at the end of the day, the punishment of Allah will follow you. And it will follow you in this world before the hereafter. The punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come onto you in this world before the hereafter. It's not worth it to neglect Allah's commandment. Wallahi, it's not worth it for you to say, I don't want to fast the month of Ramadan just because I don't feel like fasting the month of Ramadan. At the end of the day, when you stand in front of Allah Azza wa Jal, you will wish that your whole life was fasting. You will wish that you fasted not only the month of Ramadan, but every single day of your life after you see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had prepared for those who disobey him and those who do not fast the month of Ramadan. A man will stand in front of Allah in the hereafter. And this man is from the type of people who neglected fasting, neglected paying zakat, neglected praying the prayers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cast him in the hellfire. But before he goes to the hellfire, Allah azza wa jalla will say to him, Oh my servant, if you had this whole world full of gold, would you give me that in return for me to save you from the hellfire? So the servant of Allah, after he saw the Day of Judgment and standing in front of Allah Azza wa Jal and the hellfire, he realized that he had made the wrong things. He realized he had made the wrong decisions. He realized that he had committed the wrong sins. And there he'll say, yes, Ya Allah, I'll give you. If I had this whole world full of sin, if I had this world full of gold, I'll give it to you in return. Just save me from the hellfire. Yes, Ya Rab, I'll give it to you. But save me from the hellfire. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, You are a liar. I asked you for something smaller than that, and you didn't give it to me. I asked you to pray five times a day and you didn't. And I asked you to fast the month of Ramadan and you didn't. And now you claim, if you had this whole world full of gold, you give me that in return to save you from the hellfire. You are a liar and you are ending up in the hellfire. My brother and my sister, wallahi, it's not worth it. It is not worth it if you think about it, that we do not fast the month of Ramadan or a day of the month of Ramadan to be casted in the hellfire and to be in the hellfire, to drink from the hellfire and to eat from the hellfire. Let us think. We need to rethink. And I'm saying to my brother and my sister, those who do not fast and neglect fasting in the month of Ramadan, it is not worth it for you. You rather have patience. You rather have patience on the heat of this dunya, this world, and the starvation of this world, than having patience of the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter. And why should you neglect an opportunity like the month of Ramadan? The month of Ramadan is that beautiful month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens up the gates of mercy and he closes the gates of the hellfire. It is that beautiful month that the beginning of that month is a mercy from Allah. Halfway through that month is forgiveness from Allah. The last part of that month is saving from the hellfire. Why should you neglect a month like this beautiful month? A beautiful month, a great month that the Sahaba used to look forward to. They used to look forward to the month of Ramadan. When the month of Ramadan is to come, it's like the most happiest moment for them. And when the month of Ramadan ends, it used to be the most saddest moment for them. This is the true believer. The true believer looks forward to the moment that he could please Allah. The believer looks forward to the moment that he could get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The believer looks forward to the moment that he could obey his Lord, not disobey his Lord. How could someone live with themselves knowing they've disobeyed their Lord? How could you sleep the night knowing that you've disobeyed Allah, but not fasting a day of the month of Ramadan? It is a major sin. It is a major sin. The Sahaba would not sit down or socialize with someone who never used to fast the month of Ramadan. So I advise you, my brother and my sister, to start fasting the month of Ramadan. If you have not fasted before, to start fasting and make up those days that you owe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as those days are a debt. There are a debt around your neck to Allah Azza wa Jalla that you need to pay Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before it's too late. As Allah Azza wa Jalla will always accept the repentance of those who sincerely want to repent to Him. So seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness for not fasting the month of Ramadan or a day of the month of Ramadan. And remember, if you fast the rest of your life, it is not enough to make up that one day. To make up that one day. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that Allah says, "As-sawmu li wa ana ajzi bih." All the rest of the actions and the good deeds that we do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had assigned angels to record the good deeds of those actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had assigned angels to record them. Except fasting, Allah Himself had assigned Himself to record the rewards of those who fast. What a beautiful thing. Why miss out on it? Why miss out on such a beautiful reward? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that will be recording your rewards. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that's going to give you your rewards. Such a beautiful day, such a beautiful month, the month of Ramadan. A month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the sunnah equivalent to the farida, and the farida equivalent to 70 times. One reward is equivalent to 70 times. Every good that you do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you more in that month than any other month. Allah gives you a lot more rewards in that month than any other month. Allah gets you closer to Him in that month than any other month. You should not even think about whether you should fast the month of Ramadan or not. But what your worry should be and your stress should be, what could you do more in the month of Ramadan? What could you do more in the month of Ramadan? What could you pray more in the month of Ramadan? What could you give more in the month of Ramadan? That's your stress and that's your worry. That's the stress of the believer and the worry. Not thinking whether I should be fasting the month of Ramadan or not. That thought should not even exist in the mind of a believer. A believer does not even think of disobeying his Lord. A believer does not even think of committing the haram. Because at the end of the day, the believer relies on his Lord. The believer, all he wants is the pleasure of his Lord, not to displease his Lord. So my brother or my sister, if you do not fast or you miss out on one day of the month of Ramadan, you are committing a major, major sin. Not just a sin, a major sin. And you need to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to repent to Allah azza wa jal, a sincere repentance. And you need to stop doing that and start fasting the month of Ramadan. And not only that, but make up the days that you missed out in the previous years of the months of Ramadan, because it is a debt around your neck. So fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and know that this is a sin. A major sin from the major sins that the Sahaba said that we never used to see anything more major than someone stopping the prayers, paying the zakat and not fasting the month of Ramadan. So let us repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah azza wa jal for His support and help. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who listen and hear, act upon what they listen and hear. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك